So what is BC? H. Then I need to find A. AB, right? AB can find or not? I only know radius. Radius is 20. So I know radius is 20. I know this is H. Means I can find this, right? I can find AO, right? So how to find AO? Pythagoras theorem. Do you find AO? Didn't at all, huh?
Okay.
So you want to find AO. So AO equals to square root 20 square minus H square. How many do I have? How many AO do I have?
One.
One AO, of course. But AB is how many AO? Two times as AO, right? So therefore, area equals to 2H square root 400 minus H square.
Oh.
Because of the fact there, AB equals to 2 times of AO. It's not you stupid, it's you don't let it go. Now,
now A has a different value, so what must I do? D A over D H.
Easy or difficult? Nixon, what rule is this? Yes. You guess, huh? You know.
Yes.
Good.
Yes.
So
you want to differentiate as a product rule, so you copy the first one to differentiate the second one.
Of course, the easier way is change the square root to power half. Then it becomes simpler, Next one, help me. 2h, I copy the first one. Then I differentiate the second one. What do I do? Bring half down. Copy. Power minus half. Minus 2h. Okay, so complete the rest. I plus what? 2. Then copy the 400 minus h square. The one 400 minus h square, change the square root to power half. Do I even need to simplify? Answer is no. You stop here. You stop here. Don't simplify.
The more you simplify, the more mistake you get. Don't need to simplify. Continue. Now it says what? I want to find stationary point, right?
Find the value of h where a has a stationary point. So the a over dh equals to what?
Zero.
Then you want to find h. Now I show you how you can do without simplifying. First, you take out a scissors. You cut this. You paste. You let this be zero. Next, what you can do is,
I have two terms here, right? So I can do a bring over.
Bring something over. So which one do I bring over? This is 2h. I simplify to make it look simpler. This is negative 2h times half. So what do I get? Negative 2h squared. Divide by 400 over h squared power half. Plus 2, 400 minus h squared power half equals 0. Two ways to move from here.
Either you make these two the same denominator, or you bring over, you cross multiply. Which way do you prefer?
Bring over, cross multiply. I think I want to bring the negative over. Right? So I have 2, 400 minus h squared half equals 2h squared, 400 minus h squared half. Not cancel, but when I multiply over, what will happen to these two? Become power?
Power
1, right? Because half times half give you the power plus together, right?
Yeah.
So 2 400 h power 1 square is equals to 2h square. Can I stop the video here?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
You just rainbow inside and then you factorize and then you solve the answer.
Okay.
Oh, there's no more space. Oh dear. Alright, part 3.
No, how do we
do? Part 3 can do. For the stationary value, state whether is it maximum or minimum. What must I do? First derivative test or second derivative test?
Second.
Second die lah. Why?
Yeah. Oh yeah, okay.
Look at your dA over dH. Right here, I have one product rule times one product change rule. So up to you, I can do second derivative or you can use first derivative.
Can you shut that? Can you?
Because you need to test whether the value is positive or negative, right? Who need me to demonstrate the first derivative test? Do you remember?
Yeah.
You still remember?
Yeah.
So, first derivative test. Help me recap the answer. H equals to what? 14.1. So what you need to do is to draw a table. This is 14.1. This is H. This is the A over the H. This is 0. What do I mean? You sub H equals to 14.1 inside here, it will be 0. This part clear? Now over here, you need to plus minus 0.1. So here you can use 14.0. Here you can use 14.2. Then you see whether it's plus or then minus. If it's plus or plus here, minus here means it looks something like that. So it's maximum. If this is minus, this is plus, you have something like that. There is minimum. If it's like that,
tell me, everyone, if it's first derivative that the head is go up, horizontal go up,
point reflection.
Huh? Point reflection. Point reflection. Who else say point reflection? Blue one is maximum, red one is minimum, the green one? Point reflection. Well done. Girls, go to the back. Girls at the back. Go up. Horizontal, go up.
Or come down. Horizontal, come down. These two set. What can you conclude?
Point reflection. Point reflection.
Answer is? No solution. Very good. Answer is no conclusion.
No. What I want to highlight is the other one.
When the square y over j square equals 0. Then it's no conclusion. It's not only
So the rest of you know this is more adventure, but when this is 0 happen, this is no conclusion. Then you have to do the
process. Sorry, my brother, I'll cut away. So 9 is okay, huh? So I go to 10.